We'll do a stereo wild track to cover all these interior shots of the ground, the GVs. Okay, we'll use this as a stereo wild track to cover all these GVs of the rigging in the ground. That's the footsteps on gravel sound effects. We'll run the wild track from now. Perhaps we won't. Okay, take two for this wild track. Try and run for about a minute and a half.
But what do you think then? I think we should have. We need a shot. Need close-ups of Keegan, and we need close-ups of Dalglish.
Leave it that way around then, Jeff.
If we move the 55 from behind the goal to reverse angle
reverse
camera 9,
angle, yeah, that's probably the best
that
one.
That would give us the close-up. I know that we won't get so tight at the far end, but you know, we sacrifice a little bit there. If Keegan is going, but
I don't mind.
Yeah. Well, I think we do that.
Okay.
So that means. Camera 9 will have the 55.
Yeah.
And camera 7 take the 20.
The 20.
Yeah. Yeah. Times 2.
It's still getting fairly tight.
That's all right. Well, we'll do that. Good. You can do that tonight.
Maybe a slight problem in the second half when it gets dark.
What, on the 55?
No, on the 20-1 times.
Yeah, it won't get so tight. That's true.
But that's only the far
end. We'll bear it on. We'll do that.
Okay.
All right.
Yep.
Done.
Okay.
Right.
Right.
That's over.
Okay. Running now. Got away.
Cut by the mixer.
Cut by the mixer. No, you don't want to cut with these. It can be this quick too. Where's 10? Mark, are you there at the tunnel yet? Can you go up the tunnel? I'm looking for a shot of the teams coming onto the pitch. We've got that lit, Mark, haven't we?
We have got it lit. It could be in shot, though.
All right. Just stop
we'll
under the lamp.
Look. We'll have a look.
Stop under the lamp, Mark.
If you have a look at the shots.
Yeah. Is
we'll
Dave Bowden about?
To strike any of those lights, because we may have to.
He's just going
to
get a stone on, John.
Oh, is he?
He'll be after the scanners.
Oh, right, okay. What I'll be looking for there, Mark, is the teams coming through. They come out of the doors on the left there. And then, you know, really tight, big faces as they come down the steps.
Yes. Newcastle from the right, the away team, Blackburn from the left.
Yeah, yeah, that's right.
Dave.
And then don't pan with them. Let them go through shot until you get to the last one. The last guy comes up to you. And then pan with him and take him down the tunnel. Okay. Just go tight on the handles of the doors. Let's see how tight you can get up there with the light.
There's no light on at the moment.
No.
Which is not bad.
That's not bad, is it, if there's no light on? I mean, it'll look great. Let's get some great pictures there.
Hello.
Okay. Good, Mark. That's fine. That's where I want you to be for the start of the programme. Afterwards, of course, you know your position for interviews afterwards, don't you? Lovely. Okay, good. Now, Brian on 7. I didn't really get a chance to look at you yesterday.
I want us to keep talking to you, Lee.
How tight can you go on the benches there, Brian? I know you've got that new lens on now, that 20-1. Is he up there? No, Brian Madison. Not there.
Silence.
Yeah. Mark on 9, we've had a look at you, haven't we? We've seen your shot on the far side. Yeah.
Oops.
Now, I've got a feeling that the Blackburn supporters would be...
Sure.
7.
It's
you're not leaping. Repinning 7. No. So you're there now, Brian, you can hear me, can you?
Certainly can, yes.
Okay.
Engineering can also hear me.
No. Engineering, can they hear you?
They don't want to.
Rax, can you hear some?
Yeah.
We can,
all
the time.
Okay. Zoom into the tunnel for me, Brian, would you?
Smile, everyone, can the camera.
And what's the, that's your tightest, is it, on that with that 20-1 times 2?
No,
it's
times
2.
Oh, that's a times 2, well, that's not bad. You see, you could help me out there a bit with teams coming on and going off the pitch, really. I know that Johnny Lord will be down there, but that's not a bad shot. That could help me. You could get both benches in the shot there, Brian, which looks quite nice. Okay, if there's any, there might be a little bit of interaction between the two benches, and that would be nice. Okay. Rex on 6. That shot to your left, looking into the crowd. Yes.
Yeah.
That's a nice shot when the teams come out because you get
the crowd,
lots of good effect.
Group,
you know,
yeah.
Yeah.
Sure.
Bear that in mind. 8 is not there yet. Alan's gone. Era.
Okay.
When Blackburn are on the attack.
Cheers, Brian.
Full length. Okay, all the time full length. But bearing in mind that anybody close to him is liable to, you know, there's going to be a little bit of conflict between the attacker and the defender. So. Keep them both in frame. But you follow Shearer when Blackburn are attacking, and let's say Beardsley when Newcastle are attacking. That may change. I mean, if Cole is having, you know, storming first few minutes, then we might change that and switch you to Cole. But let's say at the moment it's Shearer and Beardsley. Okay. Mark's there. That's where we envisage doing the interviews, is that right?
Just want to make sure that light...
Just a quick one, John. Those mics are out on 18-yard lines, if you want to have a look, make sure they don't obscure too much.
They don't get in your way, Johnny Lord, do they?
No, not really.
No.
I don't think by the time the crowd are...
Yeah. What about the other end, John?
It's
all our boys in the way, is it?
Yeah, fat bastard. Yeah.
Right, okay. Won't see that.
It's hardly noticeable.
No, that'll be fine. Once there's a crowd in behind that, you won't see it.
That's I'll right. Paint it red then.
Paint it red, yeah. Nice one, yes. Then we'll paint all the crowd red, Liz. We'd find a way around it.
Where is the Blackburn area?
I think it's at the...
Well, it's the empty bit.
Yeah, it's there.
Might be too close.
Yeah, it's the bit that they haven't put
just
the seats
in. Checking talk back from the linking scanner to BT.
Right. I think I'm reasonably happy with cameras now then, boys. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. No, 8 still not there. He's gone PSC. 9, 10, 11 and 12. That looks as if 11 sorted now, Peter. Is that right?
Yeah.
Do you want to stay? Okay, stay there. Get a presenter.
Okay.
Downstairs, please. X, Y has got the champagne glasses, X has got the helter skelter, Y and Z has got spinning BT in the cup. You just, you know, I don't mind which, you choose the replays. All I would ask is that the first replay is a high angle.
Check, we'll give you usually either camera one, high behind, or one of the 18 yards, as a rule of thumb.
Fine.
Or we can do it off they will appreciate that on a live
game. Yeah, well, it'll be BT X, Y and Z, check.
Yes, X, Y, Z.
Yeah. And we'll have a chat at lunch anyway.
Yes, alright, and I've told you, you've got the message, you've got the angle.
Would you like to say a little bit
I go down.
Handy bit.
Hello? I can. Keep looking. Go on, Vivian.
Christopher.
No, I just thought, yeah. Just a little bit. Got me going a bit.
Microphones, do we have?
I want you to go and count the number of steps up there.
It's a long way. It's the last six. Where are you going to put it now? Can you put it on that side of the tire for me? Look at us. Look at us. Oh, dates. Water.
Telecom charge card live from St James's Park. This is Radio Magpie on 14:13 AM. By the way, today's match is sponsored by Renault Trucks North East. Thank you very much indeed for their support. And thanks to the Smurfy Tubes Garrow Plant, because they are today's matchball sponsors. The latest team news coming up shortly, that's directly after this.
I can take the microphone.
Switch talk back to John. Is he
okay? How's that? Okay. Best of luck.
Thank you. Thanks.
Yes, he was, John.
Oh, good. Okay.
Best of luck, Pete.
Trev, you happy about
2 minutes to transmission?
Do you want to pick the man in the match now, Trev?
Yeah,
get it out of the way.
Best of luck. I'm just checking up in here.
I won't tell you what you said, John.
Good shot. Sorry. Looks a little bit grumpy.
Celebrating Elvis Presley's 60th birthday, BBC Two now presents the musical The Chaplain.
Do you want any players at the top? Say again.
Do you want any players at the top?
No. No, I don't.
Good luck, John.
Six goals.
Let's hope.
Where's the clock? Cracky. Got the clock. Uh-oh.
5 seconds to transmission.
I'm discovering he's now the grandson of heir to a very rich
I heard
girl.
I'm glad to know you.
Lord Fauntleroy embarks on his new life of luxury.
What's the point of being an hour's out of the last part?
30 seconds to TX, boys.
Keeping a little lad away from his mother. I think his lordship's cruel, and I don't care who knows it.
20 seconds.
Episode 2 of this classic tale, Little Lord Fauntleroy, continues this evening at 5 on BBC One.
Mark, when you bring the teams out, I need both sets of players. I think they'll come out together on being wrong.
With Newcastle United against Blackburn Rovers, Desmond Lynham introduces match of the day, the road to Wembley.
Titles on the air, and the players are mingling in the top of the tunnel. We don't need them this early.
50 seconds on the title.
It's only flowers, it's only the boy flowers. Okay, we're live, boys.
FA Cup tie of the season. Good afternoon. This is, of course, the match that would have graced the final itself, but of course, it's not to be. Newcastle United against Blackburn Rovers.
Cut to Coleridge.
Kevin Keegan has produced this great footballing success story here on Tyneside, but his team has hiccuped a bit recently. Today may be the day for a return to form.
3, 2, 1.
English football's great strike forces will be on view. Andy Cole. Anxious to refine that great goal-scoring touch.
By Andy Cole.
And Peter Beardsley, creator and scorer, supreme.
What a beautiful strike.
What a beautiful strike.
For Blackburn, SAS, 40 goals between them. Alan Shearer.
Alan Shearer's play. 5 seconds.
Taken with all the power and authority which marks so much of Alan Shearer's play.
And
his partner, Chris Sutton.
Sutton is away, plus 2-5.
Shearer is up with Sutton, and Sutton is away.
2-1.
I can take the microphone.
Switch talk back to John. Is he
okay? How's that? Okay. Best of luck.
Thank you. Thanks.
Yes, he was, John.
Oh, good. Okay.
Best of luck, Pete.
Trev, you happy about
2 minutes to transmission?
Do you want to pick the man of the match now, Trev?
Yeah,
get it out of the way.
Best of luck. I'm just checking up in here.
I won't tell you what you said, John.
Good shot. Sorry. Looks a little bit grumpy.
Celebrating Elvis Presley's 60th birthday, BBC Tina presents the musical The Chaplain.
Do you want to play at the top?
Say again.
Do you want to play at the top?
No. No, I don't.
Good luck, John.
6 goals.
Let's hope.
Where's the clock? Cracking. Got the clock. Uh-oh.
5 seconds to transmission.
Oh, thank God for that. I'm discovering he's now the grandson and heir to a very rich
family. I'm
glad to know you.
Lord Fauntleroy embarks on his new life of luxury.
What's the point of being an hour's out of the last part?
30 seconds to TX, boys.
Keeping a little lad away from his mother. I think his lordship's cruel, and I don't care who knows it.
20 seconds.
Episode 2 of this classic tale, Little Lord Fauntleroy, continues this evening at 5 on BBC One.
Mark, when you bring the teams out, I need both sets of players. I think they'll come out together on being wrong.
With Newcastle United against Blackburn Rovers, Desmond Lynham introduces match of the day,
the road to Wembley.
Titles on the air, and the players are mingling in the top of the tunnel. We don't need them this early.
50 seconds on the time.
It's only flowers, it's only the boy flowers. Okay, we're live, boys.
FA Cup tie of the season. Good afternoon. This is, of course, the match that would have graced the final itself, but of course, it's not to be. Newcastle United against Blackburn Rovers.
Cut to Coleridge.
Kevin Keegan has produced this great footballing success story here on Tyneside, but his team has hiccuped a bit recently. Today may be the day for a return to form.
3, 2, 1.
English football's great strike forces will be on view. Andy Cole. Anxious to refine that great goal scoring touch.
By Andy Cole.
And Peter Beardsley, creator and scorer, supreme.
What a beautiful strike.
And for Blackburn, SAS, 40 goals between them. Alan Shearer.
Alan Shearer's play. 5 seconds.
Taken with all the power and authority which marks so much on Alan Shearer's play.
2,
and his partner, Chris Sutton.
Sutton is away from 2-5.
Shearer is up with Sutton, and Sutton is away.
2-1.
So Newcastle.
To feed off others, and particularly the quick-minded Beardsley will give him the kind of ball in which he can feed.
Guys,
but he's not been doing recently
when they come
what
out
he was doing
four
when he was so successful.
And two to give
that's got to work
pictures
in his
of players
mind
on the pitch.
And then it'll happen on the field.
Okay, the rest of the camera's going out.
The most difficult team around to beat at the moment, although West Ham looked as though they might have beaten
them. No need to go tight.
What makes them so difficult to beat? Why are they so good at the moment?
Well, they're an excellent save. People see the predictable bit. Only because
so you go, you need
that
shot.
Football matches mapping, that's very predictable.
Match vision.
On the old pitches,
the strengths, they defend deep, the men behind the ball, and they hit the ring.
Just
and in that
bit,
system,
crowd a
you rely
bit
heavily in the front two, Sutton and Shearer, to give you movement, to hold it up, and to score goals. They're doing that to great effect. Sutton keeps on improving. But for me, the Blackburn ace in the hole is Alan Shearer, who is the best of the best.
They drew here in the league, didn't
give
they?
Shearer,
and,
please, for
you think that's what might happen again today and get them back?
I can't see Blackburn losing again.
All right, okay.
Stand by, Motti.
Well, tremendous atmosphere as ever at St James's Park.
Stand by,
remember
stand
that
by six.
County and Manchester City play this afternoon as well, and we'll have details of that at half-time.
On you
here.
Six, pan right.
But, sit back and enjoy it now as we join our
shot
commentary team for the match, Trevor Brooking and John Motti.
Hugh John.
Thanks, Des, and fittingly, the tie of the round.
Coming to seven. Back you go, back you go, seven.
Looks like the biggest crowd of the round because it's the first one of the weekend, over 30,000 in
seven.
The rebuilt St James's Park. And it makes you just reflect
hold
on the fact that as recently as 3 years ago,
shot.
Newcastle versus Blackburn would have been a routine second division
stand
match.
By one. Hold
but,
your shot.
Two high rollers from the business world, Sir John Hall,
he's
two football clubs.
Camera
take
clear to come on the goal.
Yeah, you are.
Come on, six.
For the two teams today.
Hold your shot.
Newcastle have left out Paul Kitson. Beardsley had a late check on a hamstring strain. He's okay, and as you were saying, the strike force really is Beardsley and Cole. Kitson is a substitute, and it means a place in the team for number 26, Robbie Elliott, who celebrated his 21st birthday on Christmas Day. And I presume, Trevor, that he will figure in the midfield.
Yes, I think Kevin Keegan is delighted to welcome him back. Scott Sellers has been
nine
missing for several weeks,
right,
and they've missed that balance
the
on the left-hand side. Rob Elliott is a left-footer, so that should give them that in midfield. I think the other comparison, I mean,
Andy
Cole's sort of missing
well
out the goal scoring, but
the comparison
the work rate of Shearer and Sutton and Blackburn, and I think Andy Cole's got to sort of contribute that as well as in the penalty area.
Well, Blackburn's recent Premiership record, 10 wins and a draw in 11.
The introduction of Paul Warhurst goes back to early October, and he played it in the 1-1 draw. They thought he dealt with...
Is the referee, have they tossed him up now? Can you cover the toss?
That'll be his job. I think one of the other interesting confrontations, I think Lassau is so important with his crossing and his attacking situation, but because he'll be against Rolf Fox, and
make
I think
it wide,
that pairing will be a very intriguing duel.
Yes, okay. We have to mention as well that Kenny Dalglish is not here today. He's still convalescing after appendicitis. We wish him well. The team, in his absence, is in the highly capable hands of... Years ago were great cup sides, but you've got to go back to the 20s for the last time Blackburn won the trophy. And 40 years ago was Newcastle's last success, 1955.
Who's in the way? Coming up, Andy Cole, do you know?
So, will Cole
end his
run with Alan Shearer? Or will the Newcastle-born Alan Shearer, with family and friends watching today here at St. James's Park, will he add to the 23 goals he scored?
Quick look at Warhurst back in the back.
So, got all the ingredients this cup tie. Warhurst coming into the side at centre-back, which is where he used to play for Sheffield Wednesday until he was converted to a striker.
Quick look at the referee.
And, the referee is Dermot Gallagher, who's having a very good season from Banbury. Blackburn's playing from right to left. An early touch for Shearer. And it's Ripley getting the better of Beresford in the first seconds. Sutton's coming in on it.
Goalkeeper on two. Coming to three. And
Stuart Ripley hasn't scored this season, but he nearly put that right in the first 30 seconds.
Okay,
I'm not sure if he was caught in two lines, whether to shoot or square it across the Sutton, who's trying to make the angle square, but it's a bad mistake by John Beresford, and a goal in the first 30 seconds would have been disastrous for the home team.
Might have been good for the game, having said that, but we'll live in hope. This is It's Graham Lassau.
There's a bit of VT over there now.
And
referee, what's
Newcastle
referee doing?
A free kick just outside the area. Howie has come forward, so has Peacock.
Thank you, three.
Tom, we're going to lose that first replay, yeah?
Yeah, lose it. We don't need it now. On one.
No, we have a hot
six.
Line. Yeah. Oh. Yeah, okay, one. Cheers,
turn back to Venison. Oh, and there's a chance. Oh. That one's gone just wide.
Of that one, coming to three.
VTY.
Coming to two.
Peter Beardsley.
VTY, run VT.
This is chipped in by Rule Fox to Venison. There's the cross. And it's
very good on X.
It goes just past the post.
Coming to X.
Grammar so bringing Rule Fox down when he was cutting in clear. And I think a lot of defenders sitting at home might have thought that they would definitely have been shown the yellow card in a lot of Premier League games. And this FA Cup one, I think he should have been yellow carded straight away.
Yes,
number
that's three. To be made, and it all happened so quickly in the first half. It's Henningberg. Touch on by Shearer to Ripley. Sutton is in the middle.
One.
Ripley's cross.
Two again.
And it comes off Rob Lee, but Sutton will get it nonetheless.
One.
And it, not very well cleared. Atkins to Sherwood. Lassau overlapping. He's checked now by Venison.
Coming to three.
Who's being referred to Hottinger at the moment in the right back position for Newcastle.
On one. Are they taking a kick yet? Nope. Five can wide.
Now Hendry's come up to join
four. Three.
Shearer and Sutton.
Five. Two next.
But they're coming towards the ball at the moment.
Stay there, three. All right, coming to three.
Trotting back again now.
One.
All pre-planned, no doubt. Wilcox's cross. It was Ripley who came in on it. Atkins. And there's an injury in the penalty area.
Thank you. Come on, Rovers! Get into him! Well, chase that claw! Come on, Dermot!
Thank you. Boy Junior. Slide it up a bit.
Colin do it because he can't.
right, Pedro.